Today we're going to talk about 3.1 and we're going to start module 2. So this module is dealing with graphing linear equations, graphing points, finding equations of lines, solving systems of equations. So again, what we're doing today is we're hitting the highlights of areas we know that you need refreshers on or possibly areas that we know that there are issues. Please make sure you watch this. Pause it at any time that you need to. Rewind it if you need to hear it again. Again, you can speed through areas that you are very confident in, but please remember there are areas that we are doing because we know people make mistakes on them. So the first thing we're going to talk about is the rectangular coordinate system. So remember that this is my x-axis. And any x-axis has a x-intercept, which means that it has a y-value of 0 because we did not go up or down. So if I go to the right, it's a positive x. If I go to the left, it's a negative x. My y-axis is going up if it's a positive y, down if it's a negative y. And there is going to have a y-intercept, which means we did not go left or right, which means x equals 0. You're going to see both of these again. These are super important for you to understand. Please understand that an x-intercept has an x value. It didn't go up or down, so it has a y-value of 0. Y-intercept is on the y-axis, so it did not go left or right, so it has an x-value of 0. But it is actually a point if you're asked for it. So we're asked to graph several of these points. I'll do A first, which is going to go to the left 4 units, down 5. B says go to the right 2 and do not go up or down. So that is a x-intercept. C says go left and right not, because it's 0 for the x, down negative 4. Sorry, down 4 since it's negative. This is my C. This is a y-intercept because it stayed on the y-axis. And my last point says go to the right 3 and then go down 6. Not hard, super easy to make a mistake. Remember, it's always the x first and the y is second. So our first type of question we're going to be asked is we're going to be given an equation of a line, which is linear. And they're going to give us a chart and ask us to fill in the chart. I want you to realize this can be asked many different ways. This first one is saying, let x equal 0, solve for y. So we're going to plug in 0 for x. We get 4y equals 8. And then if we solve that, we get y equals 2 when we divide both sides by 4. So my point I just got, this is an ordered pair, is 0 comma 2. The second one says let y equal 0 because it's in the y column. Solve for x. So if I plug in 0 for y, I'm going to get x plus 4 times 0 equals 8. So I'm going to get x equals 8. So my answer here is 8, 0. I want you to stop real quick. This first one is a y-intercept. It has 0 comma 2, so it went up 2. My second point I found was my x-intercept because I went to the right, but I did not go up or down. My last problem says, let y equals 3, solve for x. So I'm going to have x plus 4 times 3 equals 8. X plus 12 equals 8. Subtract 12 from both sides. When I subtract 12 from both sides, I should get a negative 4. all of these points are solutions to that line I have highlighted. And you just really need to be careful. What am I plugging in for? And be careful of your signs. Second example. Get it in there so you can read it. Says, determine whether each ordered pair is a solution. What this is asking is it's saying, plug in the point. Does it make a true statement? If it makes a true statement, your answer is yes, it is a solution. If it makes a false statement, your answer is no. So again, remember to be careful where you're plugging in for. So 2 is my X and 3 is my Y. So I'm going to plug in 2 and 3, and I'm seeing if it's equal to 8. So this gives me 6 plus 3, which is 9. So my answer here should be no for the first point. The second point is a Y-intercept. Plug in 0 and 8. 0 times anything is 0. 8 equals 8. So my answer here should be yes. Plugging in the X-intercept, 8, 0, gives me 24, which does not equal 8. So my answer there is no. Now, you're a lot of times on a test not going to be asked to check 3 different points, so please be careful on if it's an X-intercept or a Y-intercept. Super easy to confuse those when you're plugging them in. My other equation here is X equals 7. Notice it doesn't have an X and a Y, which means all this is telling you is that X has to be 7, Y can be anything. There are no restrictions. So if X is 7, we're good. So in this one, X is 7, we're good. This one, we're X 7, we're good. The first one, not good because the X is not 7.